Hello everyone. Now assume a case where we have two hypotheses. Okay, I have two hypotheses, H1 and H2. Okay, so H1 is one hypothesis, H2 is the other hypothesis. Okay, now H1 is tested on a sample S1. Okay, and H2 is tested on the sample S2. Now S1 is a sample containing N1 randomly drawn instances, and S2 is a sample containing N2 randomly drawn instances. Now since it is taken from a distribution, I can say that the difference in the error between the two hypotheses can be defined as error of H1 with respect to the distribution minus error of H2 with respect to the distribution. Now, if I have to define estimator, so what does estimator do? Estimator is going to take a particular sample from the distribution and it's going to give. So now your estimator can be defined as D gap. This is nothing but a sample from this distribution. So this will be equal to error of H1 from the sample, okay, minus error of H2 from the sample. This is the sample S1. I have applied H1 on the sample S1. So that sample minus H2 on the sample S2. So the difference between the two will be the error of the distribution. So this is my estimator. Okay. Now you can also show that the difference in the variance of the distribution is the sum of the errors of the two distributions. So when I define variance, how do I define variance? It is sigma squared. This is equal to, we know that variance is nothing but error into 1 minus error by N1. We have already done that earlier. Okay. So your variance is equal to error into 1 minus error divided by the entire number of samples. So the same thing I am going to apply here. Since I have two errors, one is of H1, one is of H2, the summation of two together will be my sigma squared. So it is, for the first sample, error of H1 for the sample S1 into 1 minus error of H1 for the sample S1 divided by N1, okay, plus error of S2 for the sample H2 into 1 minus error of H2 for the sample S2 divided by N2. This is my variance. Okay. So variance is nothing else but sum of the errors. Okay. So this is what, now I can define this as, what is your graph? If I define a confidence interval, we have, I've told earlier classes this, when I define a confidence interval, if it is a, whatever, N% confidence interval, how do we write it as? The error plus or minus Zn into sigma squared. Okay? So here, D cap is nothing else but your error. So I can write it as D cap plus or minus Zn. Zn is your confidence interval. It can be 80, it can be 90. If it is 90, we had given the value of Zn as 1.95, I think, or 96. And if it is 80, it was 1.26 or 1.28. Okay? So this is the constant associated with the confidence interval. And into sigma squared. So what is sigma squared? Is this? So sigma will be square root of, this is sigma. Sigma will be square root of error into 1 minus error with respect to the sample S1 divided by N1 plus error H2 into 1 minus error H2 divided by N2 for sample S2. Okay? So this is my N% confidence interval. This is how we derive the confidence interval, or we say that we can express a confidence interval in terms of sum of two errors. Okay, so this is how we compute the difference in the error.